This is Outdated, and welcome back to the Bonfire Chronicles. Now, you're going to notice when we load in here that we may not be where we left off. But let's take a look and see. Yep, we are back here at the Daughters of Chaos bonfire. And my reason for doing that is I had to leave the area to go farm for something. And I did a little bit of farming while I was there for a specific item. I went to the depths to farm for humanity. While doing so, I, you know, got some souls. Not a lot, because at this stage, they're not really worth that much. But I was able to level up my faith to 13, basically. That's what I worked on. I'm trying to get both of these to 20. Or I think 18, I can use the Knight Artorias sword, but I went ahead and got it to 13 so far, because you can't get much from there except the humanity. So I'm a member of her covenant, and so what I'm going to do is I'm going to use this humanity. I'm not 100% sure if this is how many I'm going to need, but we're going to go ahead and use 29 of them. It used to be you had to do these one at a time, so I'm glad that changed. Now we're going to talk to her. I'm already a member of the Covenant. Good. Offer humanity. Yes. 29. Is this enough? If not, I'll need that one more. I do need that one more. Alright. Let's go find that last humanity. Really could use more of this. I may have to go back there off camera and farm some more. But when you get to 30, you get something. The Pyromancy Chaos Storm. Awesome. And that is exactly what I needed. So, I honestly don't need her anymore, but I will deal with that in a bit.
Are you prepared to dedicate yourself to Arden? I will make available whatever you require.
Now this guy,
if you need something, ask me
he actually does sell pyromancies and stuff. He can modify my pyromancy flame, which I really need to do. I can look at the servant roster of all the people that are part of this covenant. Let's see.
There is no time for idle chat. Think only of our fair lady and what she may need.
Okay. But for now, it doesn't help me much, so I'm going to rest. I'm going to leave, and now we're going to get back to that bonfire we were at before. So here we go. But now that we have this is a done deal. I don't have to worry about it anymore. The key is getting to the point where I can do it. But, you know, Knight Solaire that helped us in the Gargoyle battle, that helped us again with Ornstein and Smo, he'll help us again in another fight here in just a second. He is on this quest to find his lost son. Like his son, like the one that lights his world or whatever. And we're going to get into the details of that in a minute, but let's just say if we don't intervene, his quest will end badly, as many of the quests in Dark Souls do. If you don't do the exact right thing, notice all the tourist demons are gone, by the way. They do get cleared out. The Capras are still there, though. But if we don't do exactly what we need to, he will end up dead. And I don't want him to end up dead. Partially because in the final boss fight, at the end of the game, the very final boss, he can fight with us if he's still around. I think I'm in human form right now, and if I'm in human form, that means I can get invaded. So just to prepare you, Matter of fact, I think there's a NPC invader that pops up here normally, and I didn't last time because I wasn't in human form, but let's see. Let's see, did he pop up yet? There he is. He is faster, but I got it, because I'm just stronger. Okay, we took this guy out. Dark Spirit Knight Kirk has been vanquished. Humanity acquired. Oh, he dropped something. Spiked shield. Barbed straight sword. Now, there are others that can come invade us, like other players. Right, if you remember here, I'm going to snipe these guys. Make my life a lot easier. Come on. Should be in a really good spot right here. And I am out of their range of detection. Snipe this guy. This just makes life a lot easier. Just make sure you have a bunch of arrows with you. And these are just regular arrows. If I was using like heavy arrows or feathered arrows or whatever, I'd probably do more damage, but these things are dirt cheap. I'll probably load up on them again later. In his head. Let's try. There he is. So taking on more than one of these guys at a time is still a bit of a pain. So I think in the previous episode I mentioned how this is one of this game's strengths but also one of its weaknesses, that sometimes you'll find former bosses that are now just regular enemies. The positive of that is it lets you shows you how much you have grown as a character and how much more powerful you are, that now the things that used to give you trouble, or potentially gave you trouble, that were actually legitimate boss fights are now just regular dudes. And to me, that is... I think that was a great stroke of game design. But some have argued it's just lazy, and why not just make new, you know, character models? I see the argument. I think it's a little, petty, though. It's kind of like somebody can always do better, but did they do, I mean, like, does it take away or detract from the game that these guys are here? No, in a way it enhances it. So, I mean, I think sometimes we just, it's easy to complain that somebody didn't do something good enough or fast enough. Okay, we're gonna head down here. Let's go ahead and just take this guy on. I want to get back to that bonfire. Here he comes. Missed him, so it was a stun. Whoa. Dang, I'm having a hard time hitting this guy. Come on. Oh, dang. That bow hit was pretty close to enough right there. Let's see, where's his friend? There he is. Right in the face. Nope. Got him. Okay, good. Now that we've cleared this guy out, We're at 41,000 souls already. We are closing in on leveling up. We have to head down here. We've got those stupid fire-breathing statues of stupidity. Here comes one. Which, don't get me wrong, these guys can be a pain. I'm not going to say that they can't. Crap. Is he going to pop out? No, it looks like he's dead. Alright, we're resting here. You look right here. You see this guy? He's a boss we have to fight. He's not necessarily the next boss, but he is a boss that we have to fight. We're going to head back this way. So we've got what we need to save Knight Solaire. I'm going this way for some other reasons. Come on, come and get me. Alright, when you get to different levels, these guys get more moves, and they might be able to like move around in circles and stuff to make it a little harder. The double. Thank you very much. See, this Taurus demon, and these guys all over here, they do respawn. There we go. Got his attention. Come and get me. I love the fact I do enough damage now I can just stun him with a heavy and then finish him off with a light. Things get a lot easier. Let's go ahead and take this one. I don't really have to go this way again, but doing it for the souls. Oh, he doesn't even know I'm doing it. Got him. Alright, might as well take this guy on. Right in the face. Here he comes. We're gonna take him out. Then we know that right over here on the right, there'll be one of those big centipede looking dudes. We'll take him out. Forward till he pops out. There he is. Good. Alright. And we've gone through all this before. Up here. He didn't drop anything there. Gonna head up here, take out these two statue dudes. The roly-poly fire statues of doom. The double. Okay, now I've got to be honest. I do not remember if this next room... Oh wait, I do remember. Never mind. That is a fog gate to a boss fight that I don't have to do right now. Instead, what we're going to do is go this way. This is a treasure over there. We'll get it in a minute. For now, I want to run over here. I think there might be a treasure hidden all the way down here. Well, there is a message. It's probably going to tell me I wasted my time. Sorrow. Yeah, all that running for nothing. Okay, heading back, so... Oh, come on. Get up there. There we go. The good news about doing that, though, is I come back, and in case there's one hiding behind one of these pillars from the other direction, I can see it. So there's a couple of boss fights near here. One of them is another example of possible recycling. Although this one's, I mean, we've had a couple of these and would have a third. Okay, let's see, can I make this? Made it. Alright. Let's head over here. I know there's a treasure. Here it is. Soul of a Brave Warrior. And just double checking down here. I don't think there's anything, but we might as well double check. And this will probably say sorrow as well. Yep. Sorrow. Alright. So here's the kicker. We've gotten onto this ledge. But how do we move forward? You can't really climb back up where we just were. As you're about to see, it's like a one-way ticket to being dead. But there is a way. Come on. That branch right there became a bridge that made it down. We could have gone down that, but we didn't. We're about to. You just have to find the spot where it lines up with where you are. There it is, right there. All right. And if we can drop and land on it, we won't take that much damage. Oh, and this is it. This is where we can save him, I think. But here we go. Here goes nothing. Got it. Good. And we're going to go down this way. Just making sure there's nothing here. But if I remember correctly, there's absolutely nothing here. It's just a big old dead end. Okay. But it's fun to bust those, I guess. Okay, as we go... Can I destroy that one? Yeah. Alright, you see these guys? They're largely harmless. But we want to get rid of them anyway. You can farm some stuff off of them. Did I get one from that one? No. You can farm some things off of... Hey, there's one. Let's see. Sunlight metal. And those are a place where you can improve a covenant. Now, normally this would be blocked off. But because I did what I did and made it to the high ranking of the Chaos Covenant, I can open it. If I didn't give those 30 humanity, I could not open it. And because of that, our boy Solaire would die. Because there's one of these specifically we want to kill. Oh, come on. You're annoying me. Seriously? Oh my lord, come on. There we go. Got them both. Okay, I feel like there's one more. Or did I already get him? Alright, we may have messed this up somehow. No, that was him. That was him. Oh wait, there's another one over there. Sunlight maggot. Okay, the sunlight maggot, if I did not kill this thing, it would get on top of Knight Solaire and it would kill him. That would be bad. Just to be clear, that would be very bad. Okay. Now you can see way off down there, there's a Titanite demon. This is the only Titanite demon in the game that actually respawns. And once we go across that path, we are actually in Lost Izalith. But we do not want to go there right now. We have saved Knight Solaire, and that was the goal. So what I'm doing right now is heading back to the bonfire. And my reason for doing so is I've got a lot of souls here I don't want to lose. So I'm going to see if I have any pocketed souls that I can go ahead and level up once and use these. Because there's a boss fight through the next fog gate. And then there's another one after that, I think. And both of which, there's items we can use from one of them. So I don't want to mess with him right now. I'm going to go ahead and head back up here. But it doesn't seem like it matters right now, but it will. Once we face that boss I showed you hanging from the cliff, once we take him on, Knight Solaire can help us in that fight. He can join us. But once that fight's over, he's going to become quite downtrodden that he has failed. Yeah, there he is, that boss right there. He'll be downtrodden that he has failed, and he'll end up getting attacked by that sunlight maggot, and that sunlight maggot will actually possess him. So we are not going to mess with that. Alright, looks like I do need to pop some souls to make this work, so let's see. Alright, the problem, Soul of a Brave Warrior is probably not nearly enough. Alright, Ornstein would give me his spear, which I do not intend to actually use. Iron Golem would give me the axe, don't plan to use that. Quelag could give me Quelag's Fury Blade. Moonlight Butterfly can give me a shield or a spear. I wouldn't use neither of those. Normally I don't use the boss souls because I save them so I can make them into something. But I really don't plan on using any of these specific weapons. But you can make weapons out of any of these if you want to, and sometimes more than one, if you want to look those up on a wiki or something. But this could give me the souls I need to make this work. So let's try the... Since I know I'm not going to use the axe, let's use the Iron Golem one. Come on. Yes, and that should do it right there. Got it. Let's level up one good time. Level up Faith. And just on the off chance you get the bright idea to do this, you cannot attack him here. As much fun as that would be, you can't. Okay, you know what? We made pretty good progress here. Yeah, you know what? We may have time to at least try the Demon Firesage. I think that's what's coming up. So we'll go ahead and give him a try. And he will look eerily familiar. He looks like a boss we've fought twice now, except now he has some serious heartburn. Come and get me. Now, I'm not too worried about the souls I have at the moment, honestly. Here he comes. I'm much more worried about humanity, and I can work with that. Dude. Oh, he didn't stun lock. Oh, crap. For you know who to pop out. You know what? Might as well eliminate him while we're at it. Not gonna worry about him too much. I just did that last time hoping to eke out enough souls to level up. Come on, Big Red. Capra. Jeez. Oh god. Wasn't close enough. Was there. There we go. Let's see if there's a weak spot. 65. 65. Let's see if I can hit him right in the mouth. 65. Right here. Alright, looks like it's basically 65 all the way around, so let's just keep hitting him. I mean, I think you can get by him without actually attacking him, but I'm not going to worry about it. Okay. Here come the statues. They're dumb. Okay. So this may be it. The fight. This guy has some fire attacks. It's going to be a lot like a fight we did a little while ago. But, you know, I'd mentioned that there are times whenever the game kind of got flack for certain bosses. Certain enemies being reused as bosses. There is one boss model that's used multiple times, and this is the one. This will be the third time we've seen it, and it's going to look just like the Asylum Demon or Stray Demon. Here goes, we're going to try it. The Fire Sage Demon. Now, I know what you're thinking. That hurt, but beyond that, he is different, because he's got... Okay. Trying to get in behind him. It's just a lot harder here to do. Come on. Alright, good. I was far enough away. That wasn't a big deal. Oh, his tracking is just ridiculous. Alright. I'm gonna back off so I can heal. That looks like I can heal now. Come on. Oh lord. Right in the butt. Okay. Come on. Oh, that was a mistake. I thought he was slashing. Wrong attack. Heal. Oh crap, I tried to roll through it and I was not ready for that. Or that. I'm in trouble. But stop me, okay. Go again, I'm running out of these. Oh, that was a mistake. Okay, I need to not do that. Okay, I'm dodging those just fine. This is a pain. Back up. There we go. Right in the booty. Come on. God, that attacked. Alright. That was a mistake. That was a very bad mistake. Oh lord. Okay, when he does that, I don't know how to dodge it, honestly. Right, that, I was able to block that, most of it. Okay, we're getting there. Here comes the butt stomp. Come on, we can do it. We can do it. Having that shield up does help. It blocks most of the physical damage. was not what I wanted. Oh god. Ow. That was not the plan. Where am I? No, not the plan. I almost got him, but he's almost got me too. Up a humanity and a demon's catalyst. Okay, so this is where we came in from. Gonna pop a heal. We're gonna head up this way. You know what? We're gonna save that for next episode. We're gonna head back to where the bonfire was, and we can make our way through here because this guy's completely gone and off the board. There is one more boss fight we're gonna want to take on down here before we move into Lost Izalith. We'll deal with that later. For now, we're gonna head back to the bonfire. There we go. So, Demon Fire Sage down. Whew, and we got what we wanted, actually. See, there's an item I wanted to get before we move further, so I may actually save this area for later, and we may go ahead and go to the optional area I wanted to go to, because it is an amazing spot for farming. I mean, like, amazing spot for soul farming. So, let me go ahead and repair all this stuff. I hope you enjoyed the episode. If you did, please like and subscribe. And I hope to see you next time on the Bonfire Chronicles. This has been Outdated. Peace.